Captain Cola.
When I saw the trailer for this movie, I thought that it was going to suck. I went into the theater thinking that it would suck. And I was so happy to be wrong. This movie is fantastic. I believe that this is the first mainstream movie from a major motion picture studio to feature a homosexual character who's in the lead. That's pretty cool, but also just now in 2018, we get a movie from a major motion picture studio with a lead gay character. A little late there, you guys. This movie is very funny and very well crafted. The writing, the directing, editing, cinematography, all of it is great. Nick Robinson, who plays the main character Simon, is great in this movie. You may remember him from Jurassic World, where he played one of those two annoying kids. But I don't really blame him for that. It was the character and the script and the directing that I thought was really poor. He himself didn't do that bad of a job. But in this movie, he's really able to shine. The rest of the cast does a great job as well. Jennifer Garner and Josh Duhamel as his parents are great. And I will admit, towards the end, it did get very emotional for me. There are a couple of flaws I have with the movie. Not major ones, but just nitpicking here. I thought that the main character was a little too perfect. He lives in this IKEA-looking house, and he has two parents that are a little too nice and forgiving of him. And also, like, the parents are there mostly for comedy. Towards the end, they are there for the drama, but it was mostly for comedy. I thought that the main character should have been a little bit more grounded. Also, there is a bully who does some awful things, like some really awful things, like things that basically should get him thrown into jail. And the rest of the characters are just like, oh, he's just being a bully and or whatnot, and they don't take him seriously enough. And I was just sitting in the theater thinking, you guys should take him a little bit more seriously. He's doing some really awful stuff. But honestly, these flaws didn't ruin my enjoyment of the film. I really liked this film and highly recommend that all of you go check it out. I'm going to give Love, Simon a 9 out of 10.